you how to scan your work and upload it in Google Classroom. We all have school accounts, which allows us to access Google Classroom. Like we can access Google Classroom, we can also access Google Drive. Google Drive is just like our desk in school or at home, where we store all our books for class. And when it's time for that class, we take out the subject book. Except Google Drive is online. It's always good to keep your work organized. In Google Drive, you keep your work organized as per subject. For me, I think I should have each subject notes in that subject's folder. For example, when I'm looking for my history notes, I just have to open my history folder. Same thing with my geography notes or any other subject. I'm going to be showing you how to create a new folder and store your subject work. First, we've got to open Google Drive. For most Android devices, Google Drive is in the Google folder. The icon for Google Drive is a colorful triangle. Once you open Google Drive, click the large plus sign on the bottom right. And then select Create New Folder, which is the first option. Once you do that, you name your folder according to the subject. So for instance, I'm naming my folder History. Then Create Folder. And now, when you open that folder, you can again press the big plus sign on the bottom right. Then you can scan your notes and upload it into that folder, which is the third option. To scan your work, you need to follow some basic points. First, you have to make sure that your book is flat and it is not bent. Next, you have to make sure that you have good light on the book. For instance, I am standing near a window, so I get the natural light from outside. In the evening, if you're scanning your work, there's not enough light. So therefore, you can also use this flash, or you can also use your phone's torch. Make sure there is no shadow falling on your work. If you're scanning in evening time, like I am now, you need to have even light on your page. I've got two top lights and a desk light. Make sure you're holding your phone parallel to the book. And not like this or like this, but straight above the book, parallel. When scanning, make sure you keep still, otherwise the picture will come out blurred.
Once you've taken your picture, you get two options. The first one is a cross, which is on your left, that allows you to go back and take the picture one more time. And the second option is a tick, to move on with the picture. If you're happy with the picture, you press the tick. On the next page, you see, the picture you've taken is going to be up here and it shows you what has come through. Below that, it shows how many pages you've taken so far. Right now, it's showing that I've taken one. Below that, you get four options. The first one is an arrow pointing towards the left, which allows you to go back and retake the picture. And the second one is a color palette, which has different filters in it. The third option allows you to rotate the picture. And the fourth option allows you to crop the picture, which I'm going to be showing you. But above here, you have the three dots. Once you click on the three dots, you get two options. The first one is rename scan, which is always helpful so that you rename it to what you want. And the second option here will take you to the settings. The first option in settings is image enhancement. Enhancement applied to scanned pages. The second option is paper size, which allows you to choose the paper size for the PDF. And the third option is paper orientation. Select the paper orientation for the PDF. And the fourth and final option is image quality, settings for scanned pages.
Then you can crop the image by pressing this button here. The blue lines show you the area that will be inside the final image. The circles in the center will bring the lines up or down or left or right. To be more precise, you can use the corner circles. And there's also a zoom in to help you be very precise. Once you've done cropping the image, make sure you've not cut out any text that you need. The lines should be parallel to the text,
For example, it can't be like this, for this will be the result. Therefore, it needed to be parallel. You can choose a filter which will make your text look clearer. For example, right now it's on black and white, I can change it to color. Or I can change it to color drawing. So then you can select which one is the clearest for you. Then when you've done all of this, you can click save. If you've got more than one page of notes you want to scan, you can always put them together by clicking this plus sign, which is on the bottom left. Once you've done that, you can scan the next page. And then you can follow the same steps to finish the next page. And if you have more pages, you can do the same to them. And once you've done all your pages, you can click save. And now it's been uploaded to that file, subject. Now that it's in our history folder, we need to rename it. To rename it, we need to click the three dots next to what it's originally called. And then you scroll and you'll get the option here, rename. And then you can rename it. And now it has officially been renamed.
That's how you can scan your work and keep it organized in Google Drive.